All right, today is March 15th. That's a Sunday. Happy social distancing day. I'm going to give you an update on my solar Tesla roof. I know it's been a while. Spoiler alert, the roof is still not up yet, but I have some good news. All of this in this video. In the last episode, I had a Tesla tech here who was scouting my roof to figure out what the specifics are for the install. All that's good. They handed in the permit and the permit got denied. And the reason being is that the system was actually not big enough to sustain two batteries, which is good because now they were motivated to increase the size. Remember how I was always asking, can we make this system more powerful? Can we increase the kilowatts so that I can get more energy from the sun? I've been communicating with them back and forth. Apparently, it's not possible. But then suddenly the city declined and said we would only approve the system if it has one battery. Tesla found a way to increase the wattage of the system. Now they're saying it's because they've innovated on the install and they've been able to figure out how to squeeze more panels into existing roof lines. I don't care. I'm just glad that the system is now bigger. So I'm gonna show you how the system has improved. And then also some really good news, the price has come down. And I'm gonna show you how. So let's compare the old system with the new system. This was the layout of the old system. What Aaron told me from Tesla, unfortunately I wasn't able to record the conversation because I was not here in the office. They figured out ways to create more panels here, here, and here, increase the system just enough so that we would get the permit. I still was insisting on putting panels here and here and here, and he explained to me that that doesn't work, and he actually conferred with the designer. I wish I could talk to the designer, but they wouldn't let me, but apparently she was in the room. I wrote this down here somewhere. So from that conversation, I gathered that you need to have at least 17 panels, active panels that are connected, that need to be at the same pitch and also the same angle towards the sun, not in this direction, but this direction as well. I don't know what that's called. The roof lines have to have all those same angles to be able to count it as one circuit. So with this, we can put in 17 in there, and this has a different angle. We can put 17 in there, but specifically also because there are vents here and they can't get too close to the vents. Wherever there's a vent, they have to stop there, but apparently now they can get a little closer to it. So these sides of my roof are still inactive, even though they are quite good in terms of the sun and would be awesome to get them. This is the best roof, and I think this is where they are putting more panels in there because they need to bring up the system output. Is it output or like input, the stuff that they get from the sun? So let's look at the two different systems. If we look at the old purchase agreement, we had a system that is 6.2 kilowatts and it came down to 50,000, and then you deduct the tax credit, so it's more like 41,500 or 42,000. I ran the numbers in the previous video, you can check that out. So this is the new purchase agreement. Old right here, new right here. The final price comes down to 46,549. So minus the $9,500 tax credit, you're looking more towards like 37,000 for the system. So what has changed? So less dummies, but more active tiles. So that price went down, that price went up. Power walls, same price, same price, same. Pre-construction, I see. So the pre-construction has been taken out. So I hope that means that they're actually going to cover that now. And it's maybe due to the inspection, they now realize there's not a lot to be done. But it also has the potential to come down even further because I was doing some research and there's actually another rebate that you can get from the state. This took me a little bit of work to figure this one out. It's called the Self-Generating Incentive Program. On initial research, I came across this program before. They just opened it up for residential systems as well, so that's awesome. But there are certain utility companies that participate in this program. So I didn't see my local little city utility company in there, so I was like, this is not gonna work for me. But I didn't give up. I wrote my small utility company here in town and said, hey, why are you not part of this program? This is really helping us out, get more solar into the city. And they're like, yes, we know about this program, and you are still eligible if you go through your gas company. I didn't see that. So I contacted my gas company, and they confirmed, yes, we can apply. I forward this to Tesla because they actually have to do the application. Hey, can we be part of this program? Didn't hear back for a couple of weeks. I followed up and they're like, yeah, we looked into it. We contacted your power company. They said, you're not eligible. I'm like, I know. And this is what I included in their email and said, but it goes through my gas company. And here's the email from the gas company that I had already contacted to confirm this and sent that back to them. And then they started the application process. So two lessons here. Number one is do your research. And number two is never give up. When you hear no on all these things, doesn't mean that it's no. I was persistent and friendly and I got that done and we actually handed in the application. There's no guarantee that that application will go through because they have limited funds and who knows. But I'm quite hopeful because there's so much paperwork and you have to be on top of it that maybe a lot of people missed out on this opportunity as they're installing solar batteries. This is really just for the battery portion. So let's look at this agreement and figure out how much that actually saves me. So this is the capacity here. They come to this number, $5,800 saving. You heard right. The calculated incentive that you're eligible for in California with some stipulations, but if you're a resident in California, you can get an additional $5,800 off your system. So we are at $46,500. Minus the tax credit, which is $9,500, so that's 37 minus 58. It's going to be $3,150 for the entire system, including the new roof, the solar tiles, and the battery. We handed in the permit again to the city. I actually had to sign a net metering contract. This is like a contract between me and the city that whatever solar energy that I produce in excess, I can feed back into the system and they'll give me a credit against any energy that I might be using in the future from them. That's the status right now. My apologies again for not updating you, but there wasn't really much to update on because we're still in the holding pattern. But I really appreciate the growth that this new channel has received. We're now at, 4,000 subscribers or so. And I am going to keep you posted every step of the way, even if it doesn't happen right away. That just means there's been delays. Who knows what's going to happen in the next couple of months. We might all be stuck inside the house. Our kids just stop going to school, and it's going to be quite an experience. But if there is big movement, I will post another video. Thanks so much for watching, and keep it sunny.